Hey guys, Jake with 8020 Media here. Today we're doing a video on carbon buildup and how to walnut blast the intake valves. A couple weeks ago, we did an informational video on what carbon buildup is, the performance implications of it, and why it's something that you should consider taking care of as preventative maintenance. Now we have our 135i up here on the lift. Before we put our single turbo on it, we are walnut blasting it. And so we're gonna do an informational guide here on how to walnut blast. This won't be specific to the 135, so if you have any other vehicle, the procedures are the same. There are a few different things with regards to how to get to the actual valves, but the process of walnut blasting is the same. So we'll go ahead and break this video into 5 different parts. The first one's gonna be tools, so we'll talk about the required tools that you need. The second is gonna be getting to the valves and the intake ports and then making sure that they're closed. The third one is gonna be actually walnut blasting the intake valves. Fourth is gonna be air blasting the valves. And then the fifth one is not required, but it is gonna be brake cleaning the valves or carb cleaning them to get them just a little bit cleaner than you can get with the walnut blasting. So with that being said, jumping into the first part with tools, there are 5 required tools that you need. There are 2 vehicle specific tools that you're gonna need. And then there are 3 things that I recommend having that make the job a little bit easier. So with the required tools, the first one is an air compressor. We have an 8-gallon air compressor, but generally speaking, you probably want 26 gallons or more. We have all the time in the world to get this done, so a smaller compressor is good, but if you have a time constraint, you're trying to get it done quickly in an afternoon, the bigger the better, so you don't have to sit around and wait for it to fill up all the time. Along with the air compressor, you're gonna need an airline. That didn't come with my air compressor, so I had to buy it separately. The other thing is a shop vac. The shop vac is going to be used to suck the walnut shells out of the engine. The third thing is an abrasive blaster kit. I got this from Harbor Freight for $35. This is probably the most popular one on the market. This just holds the walnut shells and feeds it into the blasting gun. The fourth most important thing is the actual walnut shells themselves. From Harbor Freight, they come in a 25-pound box, which should be plenty more than enough that you need to get it done on a 6-cylinder or an 8-cylinder. And then the last required thing is going to be an air blasting gun. The abrasive kit will come with the media blaster. And so this black line here takes the shells out of this abrasive media kit here that essentially just holds them and feeds them in, and the air line hooks up to the bottom of it to blast compressed air through it. This purely blasts air. We use it because you're not gonna be able to get all of the walnut shells out with the vacuum. And so after we walnut blast it, we're gonna use this to essentially blow all of the remnants out. So that covers it for the 5 most important tools that you need for this. Now we're gonna talk about the 2 vehicle specific tools that you need. Depending on what vehicle you have, the intake ports on any car are different. And so you're gonna need a intake port adapter that essentially plugs into the intake port. And then it has a hole on the back of it so that you can take your blasting gun and blast the shells directly into the intake valves. And so this adapter piece is gonna be specific to your vehicle, as is this little wand extension here that sticks into the adapter piece to spray the shells in there. So these are the 2 vehicle specific things that you're gonna have to look for depending on what car you have. Now for recommended tools, there are 3 things that I recommend. The first one is a pick set. These essentially kind of just look like dentist tools in my opinion, but we use these to help scrape some of the carbon buildup off of the sides of the walls and the intake valves. It just makes it a little bit easier to free all of it up since the walnut shells are only so powerful. It's also helpful to have a really long screwdriver just since this can get down there pretty easily and help break up some of that buildup as well. So I definitely recommend the pick set. Another thing is brake cleaner. Like I mentioned, you're only going to be able to get the valves so clean with the walnut shells and the compressed air itself. And so after we walnut blast it for a few runs, we're gonna go ahead and hit it with some brake cleaner to go ahead and clean them out as best as possible. And then The last recommended but not required item is a remote starter. We'll touch on this in a second, but you can use this to open and close the valves without having to manually crank the crankshaft. So that covers it up for all the tools that you need to get the Walnut blasting job done. So now we'll go ahead and jump into the second part of the video, which is accessing and making sure the valves are closed. All right, second step in Walnut blasting is getting to the actual intake port so that you can see the valves. This process differs depending on what car you have, but ultimately you're gonna have to remove the intake manifold. How easy or how hard that is really depends on your vehicle. We've had a ton of parts off of this car already since we're doing a single turbo build. And so we already had the intake manifold off because we're swapping port injection onto here. So that made it easy, but on an N54, it probably takes about an hour to get here unless you really know what you're doing. On some of the EcoBoost engines, I know it's as easy as 15 minutes. And so really just depends on what your car is, but the next step is to get to where we can see the actual intake ports and the valves within it. The most important thing here before you start Walnut blasting a cylinder is to make sure that the valves inside of it are closed. And so if we use number one and number two as an example here, if you can see into number one, so you can see there that the valve is completely sealed within the intake port, and so the valve's completely closed. Whereas if we look at number two here, I'm not sure how easy it is to see, but you can see a little bit of gap underneath the valve to where you can see the back of the cylinder, to where you can see the cylinder wall. And so that means that this intake valve is open. And so because it's open, we cannot Walnut blast that one because we don't want the Walnut shells to get into the actual cylinder. So this is where our remote starter switch comes into play. What you do is you hook this up to your starter, and then when you push this button, it will slowly crank the engine and move the valves up and down so that you can watch them and make sure that the valve is fully closed and fully seated before Walnut blasting it. Now, we actually aren't using this on this vehicle because we already have the fan taken out of here and the intercooler taken out of here to where it's really easy for us to manually access the crankshaft. So the crankshaft is located down here inside of this pulley belt. And so what we can do is we can manually take a wrench and we can manually turn this. And so if you want to get over here, we'll see if we can show you what it looks like when we're manually cranking it. If you want to look into the number two valve there. So you should see that valve is opening and closing. So I don't know how easy that was to see, but manually cranking the crankshaft should open and close those valves so that we can just make sure they're fully seated. I already went ahead and cleaned cylinders one and five on here. And so I'm going to go ahead and crank this so that I can get two, four, three or six. Which one's open and which ones are closed at the same time really depends on your engine and the firing order, but I'm gonna keep turning the crankshaft until I can get ones open that I haven't done, and then we'll go ahead and show you the process of actually Walnut blasting it. All right, guys, I got valve number two closed. Two, four, and six are all actually closed right now. One, three, and five are open. And so what I'm gonna do, because one, three, and five are open, is I'm gonna take some just shop towel or shop rags, and I'm gonna shove them into the number one, three, and five cylinders. We're doing this because those are open. We do not want any of these Walnut shells getting down into the cylinders there. And so we wanna go ahead and cover them up to make sure none of the shells that are spraying around go down there, just since you will get some of the shells naturally in the engine bay. So we're gonna close those up. Now, also, while I was waiting for my compressor to fill all the way up, I took my screwdriver and pick set and just went through and tried to scrape off as much buildup as I could manually, just to free it up a little bit and help the Walnut shells out. But so we've got that done, and so now we're gonna go ahead and set it up to Walnut blast. We're gonna take our shop vac along with our adapter here. We're gonna hook it up, and we're gonna come and plug it into the number two valve, just like that. And then we are gonna turn the shop vac on and then blast the compressor gun with the Walnut shells into it. Because this is an 8 gallon, I can only go for about 60 seconds at a time. So what I typically do is I'll go for 60 seconds. As the compressor's refilling, I will grab my pick set or screwdriver again and continually just start scraping stuff off the walls. And so I'm probably gonna hit this five or six times and manually scrape it five or six times before we move on to then blasting it with the air gun. All right, so I just hit the valves 5 or 6 times with the walnuts. If you look into the cylinder, you'll notice that there are some big chunks of carbon deposits as well as some walnut shells that our vacuum didn't pick up. If you can see the kind of black and yellow buildup in there, you'll notice that the vacuum just wasn't quite strong enough to pick all of that up. And so we went ahead and switched over to the air blasting gun. The air blasting gun doesn't feed any walnuts into it. It's just highly compressed air. And so we're gonna hook the vacuum back up to it and blast this air through it, which should help the vacuum suck all of those remaining deposits out, as well as the leftover walnut shells, because we don't wanna leave those in there and then have them end up in the cylinder once we turn the engine on. So gonna go ahead and give this just one blast with this, which should clear out all of the loose stuff. And then we'll go ahead and take a look at where it's at from there. And I'll show you guys what I do with the brake cleaner. All right, so I just blasted everything out with air. As you can see, there's still a pretty decent bit of gunk built up in there, especially along the backside of the valves. This is about as far as you can get, or at least as far as I could get with the walnut shells themselves. And so this is where the brake cleaner or carb cleaner comes into play. What you're gonna do is take your can of that and you're just gonna fill up both of the valves in a puddle of brake cleaner. So go ahead and spray this in there. So I'm just trying to get the sides a little bit wet, as well as mostly get the valves back there in the back side of the intake port. So you can see there's a pretty good puddle of brake cleaner in there, which is completely okay as long as the valves are closed. None of that should seep on into the cylinder. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna let this sit for about 30 or 60 minutes. While I'm letting that sit, I'm gonna go ahead and move on to 4 and 6 since those valves are closed as well. And then what you're gonna wanna do after 30 or 60 minutes, take your picks or take your screwdrivers again and keep just trying to manually clear up as much of that gunk as possible. And then use a shop rag or some type of shop towel. And what you can do is push this all the way down into the valves to soak up the water, as well as try to drag some of that deposits up with it. You do not want to use your shop vac with the brake cleaner. Brake cleaner is highly combustible. And so if something happens with your shop vac, it's possible that that could essentially turn into a vacuum bomb. And so you want to do this process manually by hand. And so keep spraying it, kind of digging at it with picks and with your cloth and shop rag as much as possible, and get out as much as you can. It really depends on your preference for cleanliness and, you know, how many times you want to go back through and do it. Once you've gotten all of the brake cleaner dried out of it, you can go back and hit it with another round of walnuts and another round of air blasting if you want. We aren't doing that just because we are putting port injection on this, and so port injection should naturally clean out the rest of these valves. And so we're not getting them quite as clean as you've probably seen in pictures online, but we'll go ahead and show you number 5 right here, which I have finished or gotten as clean as I'd like for them to be. And so you can see there's still a little bit of buildup in there, but overall it's pretty clean. The minor amounts that are left should be cleaned out by our port injection. And so that's about as clean as I'm aiming for. However, if you're not putting port injection on it, you might want to hit this with brake cleaner a little bit more and keep doing some more manual scraping just to get the rest of it out of there. But that's good for our purposes. And so that's all we're shooting for there. So like I said, after 30 or 60 minutes, just get in there and try to manually dry that out and clean out as much of it as possible. Once you get all the brake cleaner out of there, you can go back to the blasting if you want to, or if they're as clean as you want them to be, then you're good to move on to the next cylinders. Just make sure you don't open any of the valves or turn the crank while there's brake cleaner in there, because you don't want any of that leaking down into the cylinder. So that wraps it up for our video on how to walnut blast your engine. If you have any questions or looking for any advice, just go ahead and leave a message in the comments and we'll do our best to get back to you. Also, if you want any general information on carbon buildup, we have an individual video on that that we'll go ahead and link in the bottom as well. But anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and good luck DIY cleaning your intake valves.